Hello and welcome into another episode of the Weekend Warm-Up presented by SCSUtickets.com. I'm Sam Getzinger here at Husky Stadium, your home for the only Husky athletic action that's coming up this weekend. This past weekend, Husky Stadium was also home to a lot of fun here as well. Let's take a look at everything you missed from this past weekend in St. Cloud State Athletics. It was a busy weekend all around for St. Cloud State, and the fun began right here at Husky Stadium on Friday with the Huskies women's soccer team. They kicked off another week in the NSIC with Southwest Minnesota State coming into town, and this was a barn burner that needed more than 90 minutes. It ultimately took two overtimes, and at the end of the day, the Mustangs and Huskies would end in a 0-0 draw this past Friday. St. Cloud State did dominate offensively, however, outshooting SMSU 23-2. The Huskies women's soccer team was back on the pitch on Sunday to take on Sioux Falls to wrap up the weekend. This game had a much different result, and like last week, it was the Claire Shea and Carly Valdez show. Claire got the scoring started early in the first with her first goal of the day in the 17th minute. She tacked on another in the second half, and then Carly Valdez added one more for insurance in the final minutes to wrap up a 3-0 win and push their Husky record to 3-3-2 on the season. The men's soccer team was also at home for two games over the weekend. Friday marked a meeting with one of the top teams in the country in UW Parkside. The Huskies would not go down without a fight, holding a 2-1 lead at one point, thanks to Andreas Garcia and Zinedine Croyton. The Rangers fought hard in the end, pulling out a 3-2 win on Friday night. They returned on Sunday against Northern Michigan, and Andreas Garcia took over to wrap up the week. He tallied not one, not two, not three, but four goals over the weekend, thanks to a hat trick against the Wildcats, pushing the Huskies to a 3-1 win. Garcia was also named Conference Offensive Player of the Week, thanks to his efforts, and SCSU now improves to 3-6-1 heading into next week. We can't forget about the volleyball team because they were also at home against some strong competition, starting with number 4 ranked Concordia St. Paul. This match was all over the place, with one set finishing 35-33. The Golden Bears eventually showed why they are one of the top teams in the country, finishing off St. Cloud State 3-1 on Friday. They were back in action on Saturday against Minnesota State Mankato, and the Cardinal and Black went right back to their winning ways, dominating with a 3-0 sweep to go 1-1 on the weekend. With the win on Saturday, St. Cloud State is now 6-1 in the conference and are tied in second place with Wayne State and Winona State in the NSIC rankings. This past week was also the return of Husky hockey to the Herb Brooks National Hockey Center. The women's squad welcomed in Lindenwood University to open their season, and the Huskies were dominant from the word go. The top line for the St. Cloud State Huskies combined for 7 points with 3 goals and 4 assists en route to a 4-2 season opening win against the Lions. The series wrapped up on Saturday afternoon, and Lindenwood put up quite the fight for the first two periods, entering the third with a 2-2 tie. Midway through the final frame, sophomore Kenzie Bourgeret broke the tie, firing into a wide open net, helping the Huskies move on to another 4-2 win and a series sweep heading into a big week against number 1 ranked Wisconsin. Men's hockey put a bow on this past weekend, starting their season off against St. Thomas. It was the Tommies' first ever Division I hockey game, and I'd love to run through all the goals for you, but frankly, we don't have an hour. The Huskies eased their way into game one of the season with a 12-2 victory. Yami Cronulla, Kevin Fitzgerald, Chase Brand, and Easton Brodzinski all collected 2 goals apiece in the win. Game two on Sunday was down at the XL Energy Center as the inaugural home game for St. Thomas, and this bout was much closer. Zach Okabe potted the game's first goal in the first period, and then Micah Miller added the only other goal of the game in the second period. The Tommies fought hard, but it wasn't enough to hold off St. Cloud State. The Huskies are now 2-0 on the year and still second in the USCHO polls. If you thought last week had a lot of activity, just wait for this weekend. The Huskies cross-country team kicks off the week with their Waxlax invite on Thursday. Men's and women's swim and dive return to action in Northern Michigan. Women's soccer is on the road in Crookston and Bemidji. Volleyball makes their trek down south to Upper Iowa and Winona State. Women's hockey opens up a series against number 1 ranked Wisconsin, and the men's hockey team is also on the road traveling to another number 1 ranked team in the country in Minnesota State Mankato. That wraps up another episode of the Weekend Warm-Up. Remember, we want you to be a part of all the action, so get your tickets at SESUtickets.com, and I'll see you next week.